Have you guys ever wanted to watch anime with me? Well, now you guys can. We watch all type of anime and we do it on a nightly basis. All you guys have to do is follow me on Twitch and click the link in the description to join the Discord. With that out of the way, let's get into the intro. Get it again, another chapter review. We're going to be reviewing chapter 999. Let's get into it. So the chapter was titled the waiting sake I made for you, something along those lines. I think it's going to be changed depending on the translations, but I think it was a pretty good chapter. I don't think anybody clashed in the chapter. I really think it was really story based. No, we had two flashbacks in the story, and then everything else was back in the present timeline. Let's talk about the cover page. Now, it was a colored cover page. Obviously, they're hyping up more than this chapter. They're actually hyping up for the next chapter. The cover page had a lot of One Piece characters. Like I know Luffy, Ace, I think. Don Krieg, Hancock. It was a lot of One Piece characters, but they also had people like Senku from Dr. Stone, Enma from The Promised Neverland, Deku, My Hero Academia. It was just a lot of Shonen Jump characters on there, and I think, like I said, I'm pretty sure they were doing it just to hype up Chapter 1000. But let's talk about the actual chapter. So we get, as we all figured, in the last chapter. Oh, wait, I made a mistake in the last chapter, but I'll talk about that a little later. But as we all figured, when we saw the warped piece of the dragon that Yamato was talking about, we all figured, it had a little silhouette of Ace. We figured we're going to get a flashback, and we did. So the chapter starts off in a flashback, and what happened was Ace, he went to Onigashima. He went to go help the kidnapped children that were there. And so, however, Kaido and all the other, he also went to go challenge Kaido, but all of them and the All-Stars, and probably the Toby Rubble too, from the Beast Pirates, that they were on an exhibition at that time. So Ace, he ended up beating like all the, the no-name people until he ended up meeting Yamato. And so Ace's his crew urged him to go back, but Ace was annoyed that someone as strong as Yamato wasn't the captain. So they intended to fight, and Yamato just was bored because obviously she was still handcuffed, and Ace was to be her opponent. Now, we know that, I guess we kind of got a range of Yamato's power. I know a lot of people were scared. Some people were scared of her. Oh, she's low top tier. Oh, she's high first commander. I was like, what? I'm not going to say Ace was second commander level, because even though he was a second commander, I think he was strong. Maybe he was low second, high third, but she was relatively as strong as Ace, as we saw. They were both equally bruised, in my opinion. I don't think one had one leg over the other. But at the same time, Yamato was handcuffed, so she might be a little bit stronger, but who knows. And so, Yamato and Ace, they had a little conversation talking about parents. And then, Ace noticed that, she was handcuffed. And so he was like, something along the lines of, children can't choose their parents. And obviously Ace had daddy issues with Goldie Roger, always questioning, was he rightfully to be born? And he never, he has some trouble accepting himself. And so, Yamato, she got angry, and she destroyed the statue. And then, Ace starts to like her. And then so he punched the it's like 6 a.m. He punched the statue, and then, with a fire fist attack, and he claims that, responsibility, saying that this is a warning to Kaido. So Ace came to Onigashima to take Kaido's head. Kaido wasn't there, and so he broke the statue, saying this is a warning that he'll be back. But obviously, he didn't, because he's dead. So we go back to the present. Wait. Hold up. And actually, the reason why the title was, the waiting sake, I made it for you, because Ace and Yamato, they both drunk sake, and Yamato says she'll leave the island as soon as they take the handcuffs off. I was about to skip a huge important part of the chapter. Okay, then Ace asks her whenever the new generation sprung people in the world, they're talking about the new generation, and then, Yamato brings a kid. She said, yeah, I know all about pirates. You know this one, Eustace kid. Yep, she said she talks about law, talks about Benji. From the South Blue, they brought up, I guess, the strongest pirate from each blue. They said a kid from South Blue, Law from North Blue, and Benji from West Blue. And so that leads me to believe maybe those three will be the Yonko. Maybe the next Yonko, including Luffy and Blackbeard, so we'll have five. And then, or, you know, they'll have some importance to the story, because I don't think Oda just randomly picked those, because especially Law and Kid. Maybe we already had our Benji moment in Whole Carrion. I don't know. But then Ace is all like, hey, you know, but the strongest one is my kid brother. And, you know, he's set to sail soon. She's like, well, he hasn't even set sail, so how is he the strongest one? Which makes sense, because Luffy is the youngest, the worst generation. Law and Kid and Benji, they're all older, so that obviously they set out first. But we're going to go back to the present. You know, she revealed to Momonosuke that she is Kaido's daughter. Momonosuke was like, he ran away. It was funny. He was like, hey, yo, your dad killed my father. Let me, you know, you need to back up. And, you know, but she's like, all right, relax. I'm not going to hurt you. I would have hurt you, but now get back over here. And so she's like, okay, but why mention Ace? And so they're about to talk, but then they cut to Tama. So Tama, Nami's talking about to Tama, how she wanted to become a bewitching Kenichi, because of Ace, and then, Ace, not that part yet. All right, so then we go to the live floor. So this is where I messed up in my last chapter review. I thought Marco was, which I don't know why I thought that, because I'm not saying Marco's not powerful, but he can't, that's three people. He ordered Robin and Brooke to go upstairs, right, run up the stairs, which makes sense, because I think Robin, because Mike is probably gonna fight Black Maria, because she's a spider, well, has the spider fruit, and, you know, multiple arms versus multiple arms, so that makes sense. And then King Queen are going to attack Zoro, and we're gonna get a Zoro and Marco clash probably next chapter. Chapter 1000, you know, Marco transforms, Zoro's on top of him. We're gonna get a clash. We saw a Queen Silhouette, you know, talking about his, you know, devil fruit we already knew, talking about King Silhouette, talking about, you know, his devil fruit. And I thought we were gonna get the bounties of them. I'm a little disappointed in that, because I really want to know what King's bounty is. More likely than not, we'll see it sometime during Wano. Maybe it'll happen once we get an actual clash between Marco and King, or King versus Zoro. And then, you know, they're heading towards the ceiling. And then we get a flashback. Marco, Ace, Whitebeard, Izzo, just everybody on the crew talking about the reason why, you know, we didn't go to Onigashima when Odin died, you know, was because all the casualties that'll happen. And Ace is all like, well, he doesn't care. He has a promise to take. He has to go there to kill Kaido. And Whitebeard just smacks him. He's like, you're so naive. And Ace is just sitting there slump. And then, you know, Blackbeard's there too. He talks about everybody in there had high regards for Kisuki Oden. Everybody in there recognizes his strength. Everybody's like, and Blackbeard, Marco, you know, everybody, and Whitebeard are all like, all right, this dude's strong, like, ain't nobody messing with him. And then, you know, Izzo's like, and Marco said, Ace, if you're serious about going to Wano, hey, let us know when you take us with you. And obviously, Ace is dead, but Marco and Izzo are both there. Maybe we have more Whitebeard pirates on the way, but I don't know how that's possible, because Onigashima is in the air. And then we, let's see what else. Okay, so then King brings up that, you know, if Momonosuke's killed, then, you know, then everything's over. And then Marco talks about, once again, the new generation, you know, Zoro's generation, Luffy, Kid, Law, all of them. So then we cut back to Tama, and then we get a Tama and Momonosuke, I guess, not double panel, but it's like one after the other. So they both get revealed who Ace was, how his relationship to Luffy. I find it funny how Tama was like sad because she gave him a lot of heck at the beginning when he, you know, and Luffy does suffer from like PTSD about Ace's death and all that. So, you know, I guess that interaction was pretty cool. It was pretty funny. Maybe they both become straws. Who knows? I don't know at this point. And so, yeah, so they found out that Ace is son of, I think it was just, Momonosuke that found out this part, that Ace is son of Gold D. Roger, etc. And they talked about, and Yamato brought up the Will of D, so I think maybe she does know about it, because she did have actually the Odin journal, because he's a member of the D clan as well, or he has D in his name, so maybe she knows about it, maybe she does, I don't know, but we'll have to see. But she, like, I think we'll get, maybe that might be the reveal of what D is afterwards, who knows. But then we go to the rooftop, cut to Big Mom and Kaido. She's like, alright, you know, she's waiting for Luffy there. She said, alright, you can kill him, but leave Nico Robin alive. And one thing I did not know is that Puddin can read poneglyphs, but it only with her Devil Fruit Awakening, I'm pretty sure. And so, so they're going for Nico Robin obviously because her and Puddin are the only two that can read poneglyphs, and, you know, they have, if you read them, you know, the rogue poneglyphs, you're basically the king of the pirates, but obviously, the Straws aren't gonna let Robin die or get taken, so, you know, we'll get a fight for that. And so, you know, they ask, because Law was looking for the rogue poneglyph all over Onigashima, he can't find it, and so Big Mom asks, well, it's the rogue poneglyph on the capital, and Kaido's alright, it's too early for you to, you know, reveal your big intentions, like, your true intentions are too early for that. And so, then Big Mom says, alright, she said, well, during, you know, when the rocks were falling, I gave you the fish fruit, and I was like, what? I don't understand. Maybe the unofficial translation were wrong, or like the Uonomi mythical type. So he's a mythical fruit, mythical fish. I don't know, but okay. That's cool, I guess. I don't know. So she's basically saying you're in debt to me. And then, you know, they're like, whatever, but we're gonna find the One Piece. So, we're on break for Christmas break next week, and then, oh, first up, good chapter. Really, we didn't have any clashes. Well, we did, technically, in the flashback, but I thought it was a good chapter. Like I said, really good story. I give this chapter a 10 out of 10, really interesting. A lot of things happen, such a little time, and I kind of wish we had more. Chapter 1000 drops officially the 4th of January. But we want to get the scans a couple days early, so it might happen in, you know, the 31st to 30th. I think the 30th is probably more likely. It usually drops Friday's morning or Thursday, like Thursday night, one of the two. But yeah, let me know your guys' thoughts. You know, maybe we'll either get something next chapter if this leads up. We'll either get something about the D clan or we'll get something about the Rocks Pirates, probably so. But yeah, give me guys' thoughts. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you guys never miss out on that video. Follow me on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat. They're on the screen in the description as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. And don't forget to unleash your potential.